to participate in this 18th anniversary celebration for your pastor, giving honor to God, to who is the head of my life, giving honor to your pastor, and to his lovely wife, and to all of the mothers and all the other ministers. It is truly a blessing to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Oftentimes we take it for granted just being able to walk through the doors of the church one more time. Some people went to church on Sunday, but before they could get back to the house of the Lord one more time, God called them home. So we need to thank God for each and every time that he allows us to come into the house of the Lord. I'm not going to be for you long, and I promise you all, if you all pray with me, God will preach.
All right, right now.
But even if you do not pray, God still has a word on this evening.
Amen.
For those of you with your Bibles, if you will go with me to a very familiar passage of Scripture, we're going to go to the 37th Psalm. We're going to start at the 23rd and read down to the 27th verse, a very familiar passage. That is Psalms, the 37th division, starting at the 23rd verse. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
And if I was at home, I'd say, if you don't have it, say, hold on, preacher. Well, I think I may have heard one hold on, preacher. So we're going to hold on just a little bit longer. But we will go to Psalms 37, starting at the 23rd verse. And it reads, "The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his way. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholdeth him with his hand. I have been young, and now am old, yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. He is ever merciful and lendeth, and his seed is blessed. Depart from evil and do good, and dwell forevermore." The word of God for the people of God.
Amen.
Eternal God, our Father, it is I, your humble servant, coming again, as humbly as I know how, just to say,
Thank you
for allowing me another opportunity to come into the house of the Lord and stand behind this sacred desk on this holy ground to proclaim what thus saith the Lord.
Yes.
God, I'm asking you to just take Terry out of this equation right now, God. Let me decrease that you will increase in me, and your people will hear a word from you. Lord, consecrate me now for my service. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight.
Yes.
For Lord, thou art my strength and my redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
When I got the phone call to come and break the bread of life on this evening, I began to petition God for the right words to say.
Amen.
Because this isn't just any regular type of service that we are in on tonight. We are in a service of celebration.
Amen.
You see, we are celebrating because we are thanking God for allowing this great man of God to stand in the vineyard for 18 years proclaiming the word of God.
Amen.
We are thanking God for allowing him to stand in the gap for you all, the members of this church, for 18 long years. We are thanking God for allowing him to come to the church and to lay before God to pray for this church and pray for this community. We are thanking God for giving him the vision for which I am told this sanctuary is what it is on this night. We are thanking God for ordering his steps. So if you will allow me just for a few moments, I would like to talk to not just this pastor and this first lady, but to all of you from the topic, Just What the Doctor Ordered. Just What the Doctor Ordered. Now, this is just a little fun fact that I came across while studying, but a little birdie told me that, like myself, there may be some people here tonight who might bring me a certain someone called Dr. Pepper. And for those Dr. Pepper drinkers in the house, this fun fact is, from 1991 until now, off and on, the beverage company of Dr. Pepper used the slogan, Just What the Doctor Ordered. They advertised this soda to be so good that just one drink of it would be everything that you needed to make everything all right. Well, I'm sorry to bust somebody's bubble on tonight, but I know that there is something that tastes better than Dr. Pepper. There's something that tastes better than my favorite Coca-Cola, better than Pepsi, better than even Sprite, because Pastor, my Bible tells me in Psalms 34 and 8, it says, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusts him in him. Well, Dr. Pepper might be good, but it didn't wake you up on this morning. Coca-Cola, which is my favorite, it tastes pretty good, but guess what? Coca-Cola did not put food on the table. Pepsi and Sprite, they have a real good taste to them, but it did not put clothes on your back or a roof over your head. Now, somebody should have been shouting right there. But for those of you that little fact just went over your head, let me break it down for you a little something like this. How many of you know if it had not been for the Lord on your side that you would not be here? You would not have woke up on this morning. You would not have had food to eat. You would not have had clothes to wear. But because God is faithful and because God is good, Dr. Pepper is not just what the doctor ordered. Let me slow down just a little bit, because sometimes I jump out there and I have to reel myself back in. How many of you have been to the doctor for one reason or another, and when you left the doctor, he gave you some orders or some instructions to follow? Many times when the doctor gives you these instructions, there are steps that you must follow with these instructions. It is thought that in order to achieve the desired goal of your doctor, whatever those goals may be, you must follow these steps to get to where it is you need to be.
Amen.
Now, all of us know that some of us, including myself, have trouble following instructions. Sometimes we may mess up and we may get some things wrong, and we may not follow every step, and we just may fall down. Well, let me jump back to the text for a minute. The text says, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his way. And though he fall, sometimes, Pastor, sometimes even we may stumble and fall. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholdeth him with his hand. Well, let me help somebody on tonight who has had some trouble following instructions. I just stopped by to let you know that even when you don't follow the doctor's orders, guess what? God still has his hands on you. And he said that he would never leave you, nor would he forsake you. You might fall down sometimes. You might not get things right all the time. But because you have the Lord on your side, you will get up and you will It's an old song that this little old lady used to sing, and I remember watching the video of this little old lady sing when I was just a little boy. And she sang these words. She said, "Come on in the room. Come on in the room. Jesus is my doctor. He writes out all of my prescriptions. He gives me all of my medicine in my room." Well, I just stopped by Mount Calvary on tonight to let somebody know that Jesus is still the doctor, and he is the doctor that has never lost a case. And since Jesus is your doctor, tonight we find that he has some orders for each and every one of us on tonight. And the orders are found in Psalms 37 and 23 that says the steps of a good man,
yes,
the steps of a good woman are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his way.
Amen.
My brothers and my sisters, God wants you to take the steps that he has ordered for you. Now, it must be understood that having your steps ordered by God does not mean that everything will always be rosy and everything will not always be smooth for each and every one of us in here. Because while the Lord is ordering our steps, there will be times when we will face some problems. There will be times when we'll face some obstacles. There will be times when we will have some setbacks. There will be times when we will have sickness in our body. There will be times when we will feel some pain. There will be times when we will be disappointed. And guess what? There will even be some times when our hearts just may be breaking. But through it all, somebody just say through it all. Through the sunshine and the rain, through the sickness and the pain, while God is ordering your steps, just know and believe that all things are working together for your good, because you are called according to God's purpose. Church, you've got to believe and know that God is able to order your steps even through your problems. God is able to order your steps through your disappointments. God is able to order your steps through your setbacks. God is able to order your steps when your heart is breaking. God is able to order your steps when there's pain in your body. Tonight, the doctor is in the house, and he wants you to know that all you have to do is believe and know that no matter what you may face in this life, if you allow God to just order your steps, you will have the victory.
Thank you.
Now, I have this friend, and he's a real good friend of mine. He's always on Facebook now. A lot of people may not use Facebook, but he's always on Facebook. He's always posting something, I mean, night, day, whenever. But my friend on Facebook, he's posting this same post each and every day. He posts it every day. And he posts every day, every step you take, with every step that you take, declare the victory.
Amen.
With every step that you take,
yes,
declare the victory.
Yes.
Well, when I was reading the post, God sent me a little confirmation to share with this house. And the confirmation says that every step that you take, ordered by God, is getting you one step closer to your destination, which is your victory. But in order for you to reach your destination, you have to do some things. People are going to talk about you, but guess what? You have to keep on taking those steps. People are not going to be for you, but you just have to keep on taking each and every step, because with every step that you take, sit down and then we can go home. So you must do some things in order to get to destination. First, you must trust in the process.
Yes.
You must trust
in
the process. I'm sure when God gave you the vision for this church, a lot of people did not understand. A lot of people were saying, well, now, Pastor, I don't know. But because God has ordered your steps, God knew that you were going to trust in the process. And because you trusted in the process, this is the fruit of trusting in the process. Him being here for 18 years is the product of him trusting in the process. When you trust in the process, you can go to one of my favorite scriptures found in Proverbs, the 3rd chapter, the 5th through the 6th verse. It says, trust in the Lord with all of thy heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct thy path. Church, when you do what the scripture says, you are letting God know that you are trusting in him, because he is the process. And it is only because of God that we live, move, and have our being. So since we are trusting in the process, God is going to order our steps that he has for us. When you accepted the Lord and took on salvation, that was just step one. Because God said, if you just take that one step, I'll be with you each and every step after that. But guess what? Some of us forgot to take another step. Some of us thought, oh, just because I done took that one step and I done came down and I have cried and I have purged and I have laid before God, that there was all that I needed to do. But guess what? Some of us need to take another step. For some of us tonight, if we take that other step, that next step is going to change our lives. The next step is going to take us to a whole new dimension in God. The next step means that it's going to be the end of some old stuff. Some of the battles that you have been fighting, you're not going to have to fight those battles anymore. For somebody, the next step is going to break you out of some traditions. It's going to break you out of some of the things that have limited you and robbed you of having a deeper experience with God. Now, I just got to tell somebody, somebody in here is getting ready to fly. Somebody in here tonight is what I like to call being in the caterpillar stage. And while you're in the caterpillar stage, you knew that something was changing in your life, but you just could not seem to break loose and get to the next level. But guess what? Tonight is your night. Tonight you are getting your wings. I've got to tell somebody, the next step that you take is taking you out of some stuff. The next step is taking you out of drama. The next step is taking you out of misery. The next step is taking you out of having to live paycheck to paycheck. The next step is taking you out of renting instead of buying the home that God has for you. The next step is taking you out of working for someone when God said you are your own boss. The next step is taking you out of the mud. You see, you've been stuck in the mud. You couldn't seem to get loose. But guess what? Tonight God said that you are coming out of the mud. I'm trying to go on to my second point, but I feel something pushing me, and it's the Holy Ghost saying to somebody tonight that the struggle that you are in is over right now. You've been pushing and you've been fighting the good fight, but guess what? You're getting ready to
come out of this thing. The Holy Ghost said to tell you to get ready to take another step. And when you take that second step, it's going to take you into a place where with God, where things that were difficult become easy. The Holy Ghost is saying he's getting ready to take the sweat out of your problems. You're getting ready to step into a flow of the current of the anointing that is going to lift you up to places that you never could have got to on your own. You're getting ready to step into a current of the anointing that is going to accelerate your progress. You're going to pass some people by. Some people ain't ready to go as fast as God is getting ready to take you. But guess what? You're going to pass these people up because they have gotten comfortable and they have gotten satisfied with just existing in the church. Some people just come to church because it's what they've done all of their lives. But we need to start coming to church expecting God to do something each and every time we come through the doors. We need to have an expectation that God is going to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we can ask or think. Somebody tell your neighbor, take another step. We need to take another step, and we need to trust in the process because it's just what the doctor ordered.
Yes.
Secondly, when taking the steps ordered by God, you have to praise God in every step.
Amen.
You have to praise God in every step.
Yes.
Romans 16:20 says, "And the God of peace shall bruise Satan under your feet shortly. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen."
Amen.
When you are going through this thing called life, sometimes life will happen to you. And when life happens to you, that doesn't mean that you stop taking the steps that God has ordered for you. Because you trust in the process and you know that your steps have been ordered in the Lord, and he is delighted in your way, no matter what you go through, with every step, you praise God, because every step that you take is bruising the head of the enemy. For those that know me, and for those who have ever been to Harris Anderson, everybody knows that I am a praiser. I'm a praiser from what I want to say way back, because I will praise God no matter where I am or no matter who I am around, because there is nothing that I love more than bruising the head of the enemy. I praise God because I know exactly what God can do. I praise God because I know that when I praise God, I'm praising God in expectation for what I know he is going to do. I praise God because 37 years ago, when the doctor said that me and my mother, or maybe the both of us, would die, that my mother told my father and even the doctors that if it came down to taking a choice of who would live and who would die, she told the doctor to choose me. But because I know what God can do, I just left my mama about 2 hours ago and she's doing just fine. I praise God because 6 years ago, they took my father into the hospital in the month of February, and the doctors told us that he needed a liver transplant or it was going to be over for him. But because I know the God I serve, I trusted in the process, and I praise God in every step. And because I praise God in every step, on a February morning in 2012, I got a call all the way out in Las Vegas, Nevada, and it was my mother on the phone, and all she had to say was four little words: "We got a liver." And guess what? My daddy left the hospital that same year, and he has not was at the happiest point in my life. The enemy stepped into my life and he turned my very life upside down. Now I could have lost my mind and I could have gave up, but because I was taking the steps ordered by God for my life, and I believe the scripture that says no weapon formed against you shall prosper. That it wouldn't be formed. He said that it would not prosper because I trusted in the process. And praise God, with every step, I thank God that in January of 2015, after all of my family and all of my friends bombarded heaven on my behalf, I stepped out of my storm. I saw the lightning flash. I saw the wind blowing. I felt the rain falling. But guess what? I stepped out of my storm. And when I stepped out of my storm, I stepped out on dry ground. You can't tell me that praising God won't turn a situation around. Somebody needs to be praising God right now for me. Standing. Somebody needs to praise God that in a world where pastors are leaving the pulpit after 18 months, he is still here 18 years later, praising God. I don't know about you, but I'm going to praise God in every step because it's just
yes.
What the doctor ordered. One last point. Lastly, when taking the steps ordered by God, you have to let God break you to bless you.
Amen.
You have to let God break you to bless you. One night last week, as I was preparing for this message, my mother posted a story on my Facebook page. And I had read the story before, but when I read it this time, it really took root down in my spirit. The story was entitled Gracefully Broken. The story says, I was in the Dollar Tree last night and there was a lady with two kids behind me in the long line. And one was a big kid and one was a toddler. And the big one had a pack of glow sticks in his hand. And the baby was screaming for one of them. So the mother opened the package and she gave him one of those glow sticks. And the baby calmed down and he stopped crying. And he walked around with that glow stick and he was just smiling. But then the bigger boy took the glow stick from the baby and the baby started screaming again. And just as the mom was about to fuss at the older child, he bent the glow stick and handed it back to the baby. As we were walking outside, the baby noticed that the stick was now glowing. And his brother said, I had to break it so you could get the full effect from it. You see, I almost ran around my house when I read that part of the story. Because I could hear God saying to me, I had to break you to show you why I created you. You had to go through it so you could fulfill what your purpose is. You see, the little baby, he was just happy swinging the unbroken glow stick around in the air because he did not understand what it was created to do, which was glow. There are some people who will be content with just being, but some of us that God has chosen, we have to be broken.
Amen.
We have to get sick. We have to lose a job. We have to go through losing a parent, or through losing a spouse or a friend or even a child, because in those moments of desperation, God is breaking us to bless us, because when the breaking is done, then we will be able to see the reason for which we were created. So when you see those of us who have been chosen by God, when you see us glowing, when you see us praising God in every step, just know that it is because God broke us to bless us. Somebody, God broke you because you had a little bit too much pride, but then he blessed you and he made you whole. Somebody, God broke you because you thought that you were in control, but then he blessed you when you gave it all over to him. Somebody needs to understand tonight that God had to break you to fulfill the destiny that he has for your life. But tonight, I need to talk to you just for 1 second. Tonight, to this pastor and family, God sent me by to remind you of something. He sent me by here to remind you of the scripture that he has in Joshua 1 and 3 that says, every place that the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses. You have to understand that God had to break you in every way that he has, so that he can bless you to getting everything that he has showed you for this ministry and for this church. I know sometimes you feel like you're going through this thing all by yourself, but guess what? God said he will be with you even until the very end. I know sometimes you feel like nobody understands what you are going through, but guess what? They don't have to understand, because God knows and understands all. I know sometimes that even pastors feel like giving up, but God sent me by here to let you know that you just keep on taking every step that God has ordered for your life. And while you're taking every step, trust in the process, and then praise God in every step. And when you are getting broken, let God break you to bless you, because it's just what the doctor ordered. And when you know that it's just what the doctor ordered, you can sing a song that I love to sing, that the older saints used to sing, when they said, when peace like a river attended my way, when storms like the sea billows roll, whatever my lot thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. Now Calvary, God said, take another step, and it will be well with your soul. God said, if you just do what I ordered for you to do, everything that you thought was impossible, God is saying, I'm possible. God is saying, I'm going to do some things that are going to blow your very mind. The scripture says, write the vision and make it plain, and it shall speak and not lie. Yes, but some of us need to write down the vision that God has given us. It might not happen right now. We might have to wait for a little while. But guess what? That vision shall speak and it won't lie. All you have to do is just take another step. Every time that people talk about you, every time friends stab you in the back, just take another step. Every time the doctor has a bad diagnosis, every time you feel like you're not going to make it, just take another step. Every time you reach in your pocket and you don't find no money, bill letters are blowing up your phone, just take another step, because with every step that you take, God
another step.
Amen. Praise
because guess what?
Yes.
It's just what the doctor ordered.
Amen.
Tonight there may be one who is saying, I'm going through so much and I feel like that life is just weighing me down and I don't know how I'm going to make it. The scripture says the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord.
Yes.
When you feel like you can't make it in this thing called life, that is because you have not taken the first step.
All right.
And that first step is accepting the Lord as your personal Savior. If you accept the Lord as your personal Savior, God will do everything that you need Him to do. I am a living witness that when you accept the Lord, because I accepted the Lord at the age of 12 years old. When I was growing up, I was a very sick child because when I was born, 2 months premature. Doctors said that I would have a learning disability. Doctors said that I would have speech problems. Doctors said that I would probably need oxygen all of my life. But at the age of 12 years old, my mother and father were not even at church. I took that step.
All right.
And I accepted the Lord as my personal Savior.
Amen.
And I am a living witness. When I was 12 years old, I was taking speech therapy because I could not speak a full sentence without stuttering. But after I accepted the Lord into my life,
all right,
God began to clear up my speech.
Amen.
When you cast all of your cares upon the Lord, God will do exactly what you're asking Him to do. So tonight, if you do not know the Lord as your personal Savior, tonight is your night.
Yes, Lord.
There may be one here tonight who was a lot like me. You see, I grew up in the church. When I was growing up, every time the church doors were open, we were in church. I mean, Sunday morning, Sunday afternoon, Sunday night, Monday night prayer, Tuesday night choir rehearsal, Wednesday night Bible study. Something went on Thursday night. Then we had service Friday night.
Right.
I mean, but even being a preacher's kid times two, because my mother and my father are both preachers, life happened to me. And I was at an age where I said, I'm just going to do things my way. Even though I had grown up in church all of my life, I was a preacher's kid. I did everything in the church. But one day I decided, God's way just ain't working right for me. So I'm going to step out and I'm going to do things. But how many of you know that when God has His hands upon you,
yes,
God will only let you get what so far.
All right.
Before God will step into your situation and turn your situation around.
Amen.
If you have felt like you weren't going to make it and you felt like doing things your own way and you turned away from God, guess what? The doctor is in the house tonight.
Amen.
And God said tonight can be your night to get back into fellowship with me. And I am a living witness that when I made things right with God, everything started turning around in my life. So if that is you, the altar is open for you. If you just need prayer, all of us truly are standing in the need of prayer. But if you just need somebody to touch and agree with you, tonight the altar is open.
God start making the difficult things easy in their lives. God, if there may be sickness, God, we know you are a doctor that is never lost a case. And your word says, by your stripes, we are healed. So God, I'm counting it done right now in the name of Jesus, because I know what you can do in me. So God, I'm asking you right now to just keep us all covered in your precious blood. God, we love you today. We give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise. In Jesus' name.
So I'll just say, thank you, Lord.